Okay, good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning. Yeah. Did you have a nice breakfast? Yeah? So not too much, right? Just enough for meditation practice. Okay, great. So let's do some meditation again. It's always a nice way to start the day. So please get ready. Okay, so as always, just start off by just relaxing, by feeling your body, to make sure you are at ease. It always takes a bit of time just to kind of get settled in the meditation. It doesn't take that much disturbance to disturb the mind. And certainly when you kind of hang out with your friends and you have breakfast together, there's always a bit of disturbance from that. Just allow things to settle down. And then slowly, 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 the mind lets go of the past, and it kind of finds that beautiful peace and beautiful serenity here in the present. And as so much to do with the spiritual practice and meditation in particular, there isn't really much that you have to do. Most of the things is just about sitting back and observing and allowing things to be. And if you allow things to be properly, they just gradually tend to disappear by themselves. And occasionally, through this process of allowing things to be, sometimes we just nudge the mind very gently, just reminding the mind of where to find happiness, where to avoid suffering. And that gentle nudging is really often all it takes on this path. And there's two kinds of gentle nudging in particular that I would recommend. And one is the nudging that help you to let go. And that is like the contemplation or the perception of impermanence that we have been talking about yesterday. This idea that the world is really not all that interesting. It is inherently unreliable, inherently uncertain. And the real refuge is right here in meditation practice. Sometimes all you have to do is just bring up this perception very gently. The uncertainty of the world, the real future happens now in meditation practice. And the other perception to bring up is a perception that brightens the mind, that make you feel that this is a positive experience, that you are with good spiritual friends, etc. Things that inspire you, that lift it up. And this combination of detaching on the one hand and inspiration on the other is really what powers the meditation practice. So very gently encourage yourself in this way. And a critical part of the meditation practice is to be aware of the content of your mind, to know roughly what it is that you have to do. And if you find that your mindfulness is reasonably strong, that you are aware of what is happening, and things are just kind of passing through your mind, arising and ending. If that is the case, then just keep on being mindful. Have the Teflon mind, be the passenger on the train, things arising and passing away, leaving no imprint in the mind, and then gradually becoming more peaceful in this way. But if you do find that there are disturbances in the mind that are not really compatible with mindfulness, and again, just very gently nudge the mind in the right direction. If there is something that is troubling you, then have forgiveness. Have a sense of understanding the other standpoint, letting go of these things. Forgive and let go. If you have too much thinking about the worldly things, remember that your future is not created by thinking about these things. It is created by being peaceful here and now. The spiritual path creates the future, not thinking about the world. And lastly, if you do feel that your mind is a bit dull, a bit dark, it doesn't have the energy required, then you need to inspire yourself. And everyone, I think, should do this during meditation, lifting up the mind, brightening the mind by thinking about all these wonderful things we have on the spiritual path. And one of the beautiful things we have in this world is all the Kalyanamitas, all these wonderful people that practice the path with us, starting with the Buddha and ending with all the friends you have right here today. And allow that to be a source of joy that we have such support on the spiritual path. Okay, so now just take a couple of moments just to review your meditation today, and just to ask yourself very gently, how did the meditation go? And if it went well and you had some success, you could feel the mindfulness getting established, ask yourself why that is the case. How does letting go happen? What does it mean to have the right kind of perceptions in the mind? And try to understand this process of meditation. Okay, so let's have a short break and we come back and start the suttas.